I'm June Bacon-Bercey, meteorologist from the National Weather Service.
She had a dream that became a legacy, all stirred up from the Kansas wind.
Because it's going to be very dangerous out there in 45 mile per hour winds.
She always loved the atmosphere. We grew up with weather balloons.
Raised in Wichita, June Bacon-Bercey would graduate from Friends University before earning her master's degree at UCLA.
My mom was very focused on making sure we knew our roots, Wichita was home base to my mom.
Daughter Dale St. Clair says her heritage was just as important as the future she was paving for meteorologists and women of color.
From her perspective, she had the skills and the clear path from an intellectual curiosity to pursue a path that had not been paved before.
Already, cold air is still barreling down in the midsection of our country, triggering off a lot of snow up here in the western lakes.
She started her TV career in Buffalo, New York, as a reporter. But when the weather forecaster at her station was arrested for robbing a bank, she agreed to take the meteorologist job. She'd go on to become the first woman, an African-American, to be awarded the American Meteorological Society Seal of Approval for excellence in television weathercasting.
Weekend Weather with June Bacon-Bercey bears the seal of approval of the American Meteorological Society.
Her career included working at NOAA, the U.S. Atomic Energy Commission, and the National Weather Service, all at a time when men greatly outweighed women in scientific fields.
She was obviously the woman, only woman in most of her classes. She faced, I think, more issues with her gender than her race.
She was an integral part of emerging technology.
It's going to be a completely automated weather service office composed of television screens, a computer, and keyboards.
Even as she had to defend her own education and knowledge.
My mom was always about definitions. When she was called a weather girl, she would smile and say how proud she was to be a meteorologist or something in the context that would incorporate exactly who she was, utilizing the word meteorologist.
Advancing the science of meteorology was a big goal of June's, particularly with women. That's what drew her to a network game show, winning $64,000.
Somehow she knew she was going to win something, but that was her vision of being able to start a scholarship for women in meteorology.
Bacon-Bercey's passion for sharing her knowledge was evident throughout her career, even helping to develop science books for school children when she was in her 70s, leaving a legacy that paved the way for so many to follow. In Wichita, Chief Meteorologist Lisa Teachman for Hidden History.